Someone said in my last video that I shouldn't handle my plums in the garden. And they said Sharon has got a lovely pear. I don't know what they're talking about. Bloody cheek. Here we go, baby. Another vlog. Come forward. Come forward. Another vlog. Vlog. Another vlog, baby. People are liking my haircut, baby, what you've done. Eh? They say it's taking me back. I look 20 years younger, someone said, yeah?
I don't think so.
And I can prove that, because here's a picture of me in 1991, which is 30 years
ago.
You've
lost the youthful look.
Eh? I've still got the same. I've still got lawnmower wear on, Chow. Look. I was a lawnmower king back then, look. Dark glasses, skinny haircut, and my lawnmower top. Just like someone else I'm going to show you now. Yeah, it's catching on, this look, I tell you. I'm bringing it back. Anyway, we got a couple of stories to tell them, haven't we? Yeah, about the little mices. Let's go and show them what happened. Right, let me sit down, baby.
Can you manage that?
Hey, shut up. Look at that, look, diesel guy mug. Oh, by the way, Sharon.
Look at that. Trotter's independent trading mug.
I've spoke to the diesel guy, which is Welsh Custom Apparel. Any of you want to buy merchandise or whatever, we've got some stickers hopefully coming, Sharon, for the Butler's Empire channel.
Wait.
So if you've got, or if you want one of our Butler's Empire stickers...
Stop the press, I'm going to stick one on my mower.
I haven't got one yet, I've not even answered my email to him,
no,
I don't think.
Oh, when they come, I'm going to...
Because I think I'm messaging via Facebook. He's got a Facebook page, Welsh Custom Apparel, and his name's Jason. So if you want anything, message him.
Has he not got a web page?
No, he just operates off Facebook, Sharon. And he does lots of YouTubers' merchandise. So anyway, I'll have to check to see if he's answered me yet, because I've asked him to do us some stickers for the Butler's Empire channel, baby. Anyway, so yeah, Jimmy informs us, right, listen to this. You'll love this show, won't he?
Love it a lot.
Jimmy informs us he's got mice upstairs, right? Because no wonder at it, he leaves blinking takeaway food under the bed plate. He just leaves plates laying down there. With, anyway.
Cinderella goes up and picks them up, mind you. They're not left and left and
so,
left.
So, Sharon doesn't want to kill them with mouse poison or whatever.
No, I can't
so
do that.
She bought a humane trap, right? Which is nice. It's a little plastic container with a flappy door on it. And when they go in, eat the food, the door flaps behind them and they don't get it. Anyway, so we set it up. We caught one.
Oh, it was beautiful.
Yeah, and we put it in, because Jimmy said he wants to keep them. And he said...
But also, the story is this, he's known about these little mice.
Yeah.
And he actually sits on his shoe rack in his bedroom and watches him play Xbox.
Yeah,
and
so
he talks to
he's
it.
Grown fond of it, sort of thing. So anyway, we caught one and we put it in this container here. Gary gave us this, and it's quite deep. And we put some wadding in there.
This is till we got a proper cage.
Yeah, till he gets a proper cage or whatever. I don't know what he wants to keep him for. Anyway, it's another story. So we caught him in. Anyway, put the trap out again. Listen.
Why keep saying listen?
Listen, shout. Listen.
We should stop that.
He caught a second one, or she caught a second one. We had them for about 2 or 3 days. In here, living in here, and they loved it. They had food, water, cushion, and we even got some toilet rolls, you know, the toilet roll tubes. Put them in there so they could run in and out through them, sort of thing. Put the trap back up there. On the third day, she caught another one. But this one...
was a little bit bigger.
Was a little bit bigger.
So we had Ronnie and Reggie, the original two.
Yeah, Jimmy wanted to call them Ronnie and Reggie. So we put the third one in there, and then Jimmy decides then, that because this has got a lid on it, you see, and Gary drilled some holes in it for us. So they're enclosed in there and they was down on the dining room table for the while. Anyway, Jimmy took them upstairs when he got the third one. Then he comes down from upstairs yesterday.
Well, he got in from work.
When he got in from work, he said, they're gone. They've got out. The third one has instigated an escape.
Einstein.
Look at this, look.
Barney.
These are the holes there, which you can see by my finger that was in the lid. And as you can probably see, that's a normal hole. And then it gets bigger again, and it gets bigger. Look, I can't get my finger in that one. I can't get my finger in that one. The lid's been on there, like that, right? It stood on the toilet rolls. Oh, you're down there. Stood on the toilet rolls and started eating round. And look at that perfect circle they've ate through. And look, to get out, look. But what we can't work out, let's come and sit down.
I hope they can hear.
There was a really, really small one, a middle-sized one, and a big one. This only happened when the
it's
big
like
one.
A free bed.
Well, it's what I say, it's like a free, and every hole are different sizes. You've got a small one, a middle sized one, and a big one.
Mummy mouse, no, sorry, baby mouse, mummy mouse, and daddy mouse.
The big ones obviously stood on the toilet rolls and started doing the gnawing, but how have they got the little one out? Has it stood on its back or what? But anyway, so that was that. So they were back up in the room again, in his bedroom. So you've been out there this morning, she comes down this morning, didn't you? She's caught him. She's caught look, what looks like the big
Einstein.
One. So she's come out here, because he was in the trap. You've, by this time...
I put kitchen roll at the bottom, then I put food and water at the two ends, and then I put up this end, I have wadding and chewed, like, what's it called, shredded paper.
So she's put him... Go on, charge what you've done, baby.
So he's in the box. I've gone to put the kettle on, see if he wanted a cup of tea. And he's still in the mousetrap.
In the mousetrap, in this.
So I've took pity, so I've took the lid off, and I've like, he was curled up in the corner, so I've tilted it a bit. Next thing, he's shut out, he's run to there, he's jumped over, then he's jumped off the table and gone. And I didn't know mice could jump like to the height that mouse jumped. It was unbelievable.
This is the clever one. So the other two are still up there somewhere. If not, there might be more, but it jumped out of there with the lid off, onto the table, and then woof, out there. Unbelievable. But that, I've never seen that, where they've actually instigated a getaway off of like that shower. And them holes are right in the middle, so they must have stood on the toilet rolls. Anyway.
I'm not having toilet rolls, but see, Jimmy was going to buy a cage tomorrow.
Yeah.
He was going after work to pet.
He's grown attached to them.
Yeah.
He wants them. So we've had to go out and get a bigger one for the moment. This one's taller, look, as you can see.
And there's water in that.
Where, is it?
Yeah, there was, because it was all set up this morning.
Well, it's still water in it, baby. So we've now got a bigger one. And we'll put smaller holes in there until he gets his proper mouse cage. Unbelievable.
But hopefully we won't have to put it, because if I get one, I'll just stick that lid on, because it won't, I'm sure that little mouse wouldn't.
Shout, you don't know, baby.
And see, tomorrow, if I get one tonight, he will get the proper cage for
anyway,
him.
So there's enough of that. So anyway, cut a long story short, thanks to my subscriber who bought me, it smells still there a little bit. God, that didn't half stink. This is gasket paper, gasket sheet.
Rolls out here.
Eh? Yeah, go and get the other one. So there was no name that come with this, by the way, so thanks very much for one of our subscribers who bought that. And also, Sharon's going to get something else which one of our subscribers has bought us on our Retro Restore channel. And yeah, so we've got a few things other to show you. I'm going to go in the log cabin, take you in there in a minute, and show you a few other things that I've bought. Very interesting. Well, I like it anyway. So one of our lovely subscribers, here, shall I put them on there? Have bought us this. No message for this again, was there?
No, it's just that, isn't it?
And this is, I'm nearly out of this now, the old blue roll there. So thank you very much for my subscriber who actually bought us that. I'm very pleased with that. Anyway, that's enough of that. I'm going to take them in the log cabin now, baby.
Oh, nice.
You go and do your own stuff. And
thanks.
Let's go in there. Come on, baby.
You just told me to go and do your own stuff and then you're staying home. I don't mind that, mate.
Right, let's put that chair over there. Two things to show you here, folks. I've got to show you, I'll show you that one in a minute. But this is what I've been after for a really long time now. This is a vibratory tumbler, or a rock tumbler, if you want to call it that. And I basically got this for cleaning small nuts and bolts. Now, I know I've got the MC51 and a wire wheel and stuff like that, but when you're actually polishing up small bolts, it's really, you know, you get your fingers caught on the wire brush on the big rotary wheel, and that really, you know, you can get your fingers caught on it sort of thing. So I've got this little rock tumbler here. It's a Gunson one, let me show you it. And what it does, it's a little vibrating container. Now you can make these. Oh yeah, I was gonna make one, but I thought, well, sod it, for the amount of money it is, I might as well buy one, a purpose made one. And it's got a lid you take off. In there, you've got this media. Well, you buy the media separate. This one is a coarse grade one, and it's like a ceramic, and it's little jaggedy points in there. And what you basically do, you throw your nuts and bolts in. Now, I've literally just tried this out, and I've had it running for literally, might be 10 minutes, and already I can see an improvement in these bolts. These bolts were actually really bad, but literally 10 minutes, you're supposed to have it on for a couple of hours, so it's just hardly done any work. But if you would have seen the state of these when I first put them in, let's have a look, look. I can't believe how quickly that's, yeah, that, it was like that sort of thing. Look, I've only just put them in. So, and you turn it on, and as you can see, it just oscillates around. and you bolt your lid back on, and you just leave that going for about anything between 2 and 6 hours, and it'll polish them right up. And as I say, I've got that media, and I've also got a fine media. Yeah, baby, what do you think of that? Rock tumbler.
Can't see them.
Eh? No, you just throw bolts in. Look, just literally, I've only just thrown these in. Look, as you can see, that one's not done much, but...
what's that one there?
Yeah, washers, anything down to small washers. I've even got Micks Mowers nuts and bolts in
there.
What
is that then?
It's like ceramic, baby.
Oh.
Yeah?
Right.
And you just leave it on for about 6 hours or whatever, and it...
6 hours?
Well, between 2 and 6 hours, you can leave it on all the time. It's designed for that. What do you reckon?
How boring.
Oh.
It's not a woman's thing, is it, love?
How boring? Bloody cheek. This is stuff I love, Sharon.
It's not stuff for a woman to love, is it?
No, I know. Right, so that's that. I've got that on the right way. No, it goes on that way, doesn't it? Yeah. So that's my rock tumbler, or vibratory tumbler, for polishing up small stuff, you know? So that's that. So let's stick that over the back there. And I've also got this thing as well. Now this, again, you can make these as well, but for the sake of money, how much it costs, I thought I'd buy one. This is a vacuum chamber. Now, I'm going to be doing some new projects for my Retro Hacks channel, and this sort of thing is ideal what I want. You'll see that when I come out of it. I won't show you that yet. I can't start it up yet. I've got to fill it up with oil in the little compressor pump there. So that's coming up as well. You'll see that first of all on my Retro Hacks channel. But as I say, this is a little vacuum chamber for pulling air out of stuff, you know. But yeah, that's that anyway. And I've just finished work on my Retro Hacks channel. This one's coming out Friday. So again, this is a little sneak peek of what's coming out on Friday. As you can see there, the little police van, which I've had for quite a while. Oh, keep it still. The little police van, which I've had for quite a while there. And I was waiting for parts for it to come. And I've just restored that now. And that's back to A1 condition. And I'm pretty pleased with the way that one's turned out. So, and I actually powder coated this. I didn't paint it. I powder coated it. And I got all the graphics. I got the stickers. I got them little police signs and the little cones. The little camera on top. I got them all from Model Supply. Oh, hello, put it down. It's coming off. Don't want to drop it now, do I? So, yeah, that's that. I'm really happy with that. That's my little rotating table. They're quite handy, them. So, yeah, that's that. So, I'm going to be doing some more videos, as I said to you, on my Retro Hacks channels with the vacuum pump, although you won't actually see that on there. I'm going to be making resin dioramas and things. So, that's just something else I'm taking on that channel. And it's something I've had an interest in. And it's a little bit tricky. But if you've got the right gear, hopefully it should make life a lot easier. Anyway, we've got to go outside. I've got to get some stuff for Gary, for lawnmowers, because he's just bought another lawnmower off of eBay, I think, and he paid £30 for it, and he wants some stuff to do his maintenance on it. So let's get some stuff for him. So first of all, he wants a pull cord, so we'll have to give him one of them. How many have I got there? So there's one. He wants an... No, he don't need the end. He's got the end for it. He wants... He's got a new plug for it, so he wants a gasket and diaphragm. He wants a primer bulb. It's got a classic 35 engine on it. It's a hater, by the way. Where's the diaphragm and gasket sets? They're in here somewhere. Or is that in the other drawer? No, it's not in that drawer. It's in this drawer. I've got loads of them here somewhere. Oh, here we go. Over the back there. So, yeah, he paid £30 for this. There we go. Here, look, genuine Biggs & Stratton, look. There you go. So he's got one of them. He's got a plug. He's got a brand new B2LM plug in it. I should have asked him about the air filter, actually, but... gasket. I think that's it. I think that'll do. Right, so that's that. And he also wants a bit of wood cut, so let's go and do that. Right, come on, baby. Let's go and get this wood from around the side. Minor sting in nettles. There's enough of them here. Right, that bit there's the bit I want. If I hold this forward, that small bit there. Can it come through there? Put it to the acid. Keep going. It's only light. To me, to you, stay there. Right, mind your feet on the bushes. Hold on, Sharon, look, Sharon. Look, cool, look, that's it. Ready? Right, okay, baby, you're doing so well. Keep going. You know I'm holding it a funny way, Sharon.
Don't worry about it.
Lay it down on the table this way up. Okay, get out of the way, Barney. Keep going. It's a bit floppy, but... Now, what Gary wants... Now, he's got a similar glass table to what we got here, as you can probably see. And I said to him, he should have something to put on top of it just to stop things shattering that table, possibly. So get that get one of them straight lines, Sharon, and go and get a pen. And we'll draw out the size, and then we'll cut it out, eh? So that wants to be 66 long inches. Oh, could you have got a darker pen than that? Black, luminous green, is it? Over here. Right, so 66, Sharon. Mark on there, 66 inches. That's it. We're a team, don't forget. Get it right.
Oh, we've got
66 there, yeah? That's right. Now move the tape measure down to the other end over there. So you want to mark 66 down that end now. That's it. I'm teaching you stuff now. Yeah, you're learning.
Oh, I've never done things like this when I'm doing fabric.
Oh, a bit sarky. Oh. Right, 66 inches again. Yeah? So we now want put one in the middle, just a mark in the middle there, and we'll draw a straight line. Well done. So there's your straight line, baby. So go along there and draw a straight line along the whole lot now. That's perfect. Remember what I taught you? Let's pull that back a bit. Now, that bit of wood's a bit bent there, so come this way a bit, yeah? That's it. Right. Yeah, just... Yeah, it's your measurements there, that's all. I don't know what happened there. Can we just re-measure that one, Shao? I just want to check, see if you've wrote it down wrong. Because they always say, Shao, measure twice, cut once. That's it, make sure it goes over there, that's it. Hey, I look. 65 and a half, look, see? Measure twice, cut once, baby.
Measure three.
That's what I'm here for. And that's why we've done that one in the middle, so you've always got to double check your measurements, baby. Right, now we want, from one of the edges in, we want 35 inches. What? What are you trying on?
Stinging nettles.
Stinging nettles, baby. So 35 inches, do it on the line, you ain't got to go in from there. 35 inches. Perfect. Now go down the other end of the table. Why are you sighing, Sharon?
That's right under the sole of my foot and that's really painful.
What, stinging nettles?
Yeah.
Ah, well, it'll be gone soon. 35 inches along here. Right, and also do one in the middle because it's quite a long throw. In case our measuring bit of wood ain't long enough, you see. That's the only reason we do that. Lovely job. Come on, 35. That's it. And now we'll join our dots up, so to speak. All your 35, Cher. There you go. I'll let you line that up. Well, in fact, I'll hold this end. You can hold that end. So it'll make life a bit easier for you. Are you on the line? I'm on my line.
Come down a bit more.
You can do just what you like. Look what.
Okay.
Yeah, well, it's a bit bent there, Shao. Look, it comes uphill.
Well, I can't start there, can I?
Well, go as near as damn it, Shao. Look. Right, now a nice straight line.
Straight, is it?
It's straight. Keep going. I'll wait here. Don't worry, I'm holding it. I'm holding it, look. Oh, look like you want to do it, baby. That's perfect. Now we can take that away. And there's our line down there. And down there, that's what we've got to cut out. Right, got me sorted. Is that hanging over that table, baby?
Yep.
Sharon, do you remember a while ago I couldn't find the heat gun? It's now back in there on the shelf. I had to lift it up to get that out. So, has Jimmy found it again, where he borrowed it?
He would have said and come in jokingly.
Who knows? Well, I just picked it up. Not unless I did look for it many a time, but anyway, that's that. Right, let's cut this line out. That's good. Spin it round. Do the same again, baby, eh? We over the table? Yep, long way over. Happy days. Right, that will sit over his table, whatever way he wants it round. See that? He's got a glass table, you see. Slightly different shape than ours, but that now gives him a decent work area where he ain't got to worry about putting things on it and it going through or shattering the glass. That's the idea of that. Come on, baby, let's go and charge him for this, shall we? Hey, shall we charge him?
Should do.
Where is he? Oh, hello. Right, got something for you. What have you got there, baby? Is that to your liking?
It's none of this cheap Chinese stuff, is it?
Proper Briggs & Stratton there, boy. Look. Proper Briggs & Stratton. You're getting the £4 gasket set there. Measure that for you. You ain't got to do anything. And a nice Skanker primer bulb.
Oh, yeah.
Happy days. As you would, over there. So, anyone who don't know, this is Scrap It Man. He's normally dealing with scrap, right? Listen to this. He just went out yesterday and he's got a lawnmower. How much you pay for it? 30 quid?
Yep.
Got it off eBay, which is unusual. You don't normally find good deals on eBay. But he went in, he phoned the bloke up. What did he do?
He answered the phone.
Offered him 25 quid.
So it was still running the auction?
Yeah.
Because he had best offer underneath it, didn't he?
Yeah.
And what happened?
He came back with 30 quid, so I took it.
Took it straight away. It's a hater. You'll see that on his channel. So if you haven't seen his channel, Scrap It Man. Check it out. He's fixing lawnmowers, strimmers now and stuff like that. It's competition. I'll have to get him black vest like me and Micks Mowers. Hey?
Taking over, mate.
You're taking over? We'll soon find out. So Scrap It Man, lawnmower king now, he reckons. Anyway. So here's two. He's just done. Well, you've done these on your channel, haven't you?
That video for the trimmer comes out Saturday.
So this one's not out yet. As I say, you always get to see little previews on Butler's Empire. This is a, what is it? A Titan TT2011 strimmer. And he's also got a McCulloch Virginia there. That's a, you put this one on your channel already, haven't you?
That's been up, yeah.
So that one's up already. So that had a new primer bulb on it. I think that had a carb service, this one, didn't it?
Yeah, new fuel lines.
And new fuel lines on that one. So that's coming up as well. We've got to deliver that for him. Oh, baby. So as we've got to deliver that for you, I think it's only fair that you get your mum and dad a nice cold drink while we sit out here in the sun and enjoy this 28 degree heat wave, Sharon.
Yeah.
Celsius. Oh, he's just pulled it out, look. So let's have a look around it. It's a Hater Spirit 41. And for £30, it's got a couple of little scuff marks on it. It's got a plastic deck. It's got a full height adjustment on the one lever, which works perfectly, Gary, doesn't it?
All works, yeah.
It's got a rear roller. Oh, yeah, look at that, look.
You know, that would have been good for me.
Rear roller, nothing wrong with a grass bag whatsoever. And when he tipped it up the other day, well, or yesterday when he showed me it, there's hardly no work been done on it, has there?
No, not much.
Oh, I didn't realise it's self-drive as well.
Yeah.
All right, can we have a look? Hold on. You put, oh, I don't know if you can see, look. Look how clean that is underneath, and the blade has done hardly no work whatsoever. All around the front here, look, no scuffs really on it. It's not done much work at all there, as you can see. Good wheels. He paid £30 for that. And it looked like, basically, that it wasn't priming properly, wasn't it?
Yeah, sold as spares.
So, sold as spares or repairs. You've had it running, though, have you? You tried it?
I did have it running, yeah. Well, it worked priming, but I've done...
Well, I can see straight away that that primer bulb is all perished. Look at that. It's all, you know when they go sticky, look. You can pull that. Look at it, look. So all that basically needs is a primer bulb, but you will do a gasket, and especially as you've got, oh yeah, he's also got a frayed cable on it there. So there you go. Just a basic clean up. And once you get that wiped down with the old Pledge Revive It, which I use, that will shine like a new pin, that will. And that should command probably up between 100 and 150 pounds, I would have thought, being a self, I didn't realize it was self-drive. So well done. The bargains are out there if you do look for it. As I said to you, this was on eBay. He jumped on it. It'd been on for how long? 4 hours?
4 hours. It was on for 7 days.
It was on. Put it on for 7 days, but the bloke put it on for 4 hours. Gary saw it, and he sent him a private message saying, because he did say make him an offer, and that's exactly what he done. You ain't checked the air filter underneath, have we? It feels dry. No, it feels dry, which is fine. Anyway, that was that. Anyway, fantastic bargain. What?
Go on, Harry, get it going.
What you got? A little car? Go on, go around here. I can't see it. Oh, there we go. Yeah, lovely. Beautiful job, Harry. You drive better than your dad, mate. Oh, so this is it, yeah. So anyway, I thought I'd just bring you along on this little journey. This is, we're doing running about stuff still. We're like his bleating lackeys, Sharon.
That's right.
Hey? Anyway, well, I hope you've enjoyed this little tinkering about video, and don't forget, check out Butler's Empire. We should be getting stickers soon. As soon as they come in, I'll let you know. And all you have to do is send me an email, and I'll drop you one in the post, no problem whatsoever.
Thanks, Grandad, but...
Yeah, I can't see it, baby. I'm talking to them up there. Anyway, thanks very much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video. And until then,
au revoir.
Bye for now. Come on, baby.